So students, in the structure of DNA up to nitrogen base, we have already discussed in the previous lecture. So today, backbone of DNA. We know that DNA is made up of polynucleotide, means a chain which is made up of so many nucleotide. In this way, this is the first nucleotide, second nucleotide, third nucleotide, fourth nucleotide, and in this way it make a chain. And in this nucleotide, what are the three components? This is the sugar, this is the phosphate group, this is the sugar, and this is the nitrogenous base. See, nitrogenous base is present in the right angle position. See, in the chain, all the nitrogenous bases lies at the right angle position. And this phosphate group and the sugar, they are togetherly, they known as backbone of sugar, backbone of DNA. So backbone of DNA means pentose sugar and this phosphate group, togetherly known as backbone of DNA. And when this backbone of DNA attached with this nitrogenous bend, three of each togetherly known as nucleotide. Okay. Polarity. What is polarity? Actually, we know that in the structure of DNA, there are two polynucleotide chain. One chain, second chain. This is only a picture of one chain. Similarly, another chain is going. Okay, so DNA is made up of two polynucleotide chain. In this way, this is one of the polynucleotide chain. Another polynucleotide chain is also present. And they are spirally coiled with each other, but they are having a direction. Means suppose this is in a polynucleotide chain, this is a nucleotide. In this nucleotide, this is the sugar group. This is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, and this is the fifth carbon. The fifth carbon is attached with the phosphate group, and the third carbon is attached with another sugar group of the second nucleotide. But suppose in the DNA chain, it is the last nucleotide. So last nucleotide means, suppose this is a polynucleotide chain, there are so many nucleotide group are present. This is the last nucleotide. Okay, this is the last nucleotide, and this last nucleotide having these three components, phosphate group, sugar, nitrogenous base. In the sugar group, the 3' end, this is called 3' end. Okay, 3' end means the sugar has free OH group. This is the carbon number 3. Okay, in the one hand it holds hydrogen, on the one holds other hand it holds OH group, and this end is called 3' end. Suppose this is the first nucleotide of the chain. Okay, so in the first nucleotide chain, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. See, the fifth carbon is attached with the phosphate group. Okay, and this end is called 5' end. This end is called 5' end. So in the nucleotide chain, if we consider it as the first nucleotide, then this is called 5' end. And when the same structure is present in the last nucleotide, then this end is called 3' end. Because we know that this so many nucleotides are attached with each other and form this polynucleotide chain. Okay, just follow this, which are these groups in three different ink I have tried to explain. Okay, antiparallel strands. Antiparallel means, see, it has two chains. This is the one chain, second chain. These two strands of the DNA duplex are parallel, and they are spiraled with each other, but one having 5' direction and one starts with 3' direction. Means their directions are not same. Okay, 5' end of one strand lies opposite 3' end of the other. It means that one strand is oriented in 5' to 3' direction and another is in 3' to 5' direction. Means they have two polynucleotide chain, but the direction of these two polynucleotide chains are not same. One is oriented in 5' to 3' direction, another is oriented in 3 prime to 5 prime direction. This is called anti-parallel strands. Okay. Complementary base pairings. Complementary base pairing means, see, this is one polynucleotide chain. This is the second polynucleotide chain. This chain has some nitrogenous base. This chain has some nitrogenous base. But these nitrogenous bases are paired with each other through some bonds. But always purines bind with pyrimidines. So if here purine, as a purine adenine is present, this adenine paired with thymine of the another nucleotide chain. If here adenine is present, again adenine is paired with the thymine of, means A adenine always paired with thymine and cytosine always paired with guanine. This is the base pairs. Base pairs always occurs between the two DNA strand. This is one DNA strand, this is one DNA strand. Okay. And see, always paired are found between the purine and pyrimidine. And specific, adenine binds with thymine and guanine binds with cytosine. This is the complementary base pairings. Just follow, try to remember the diagram. This is complementary base pairings. DNA duplex. Why it is called duplex? Because we know two strands are present. But whenever you try to draw, we just draw it in this way. No, this is not a proper way. They can't coiled upon each other. Actually, this is a, try to imagine it three-dimensionally. These are the two strands. These two strands are coiled upon itself. Not the strands are in this way, they are coiled. Means this is not a meeting point. They can't attach with itself or can't touch with itself. Never the both strands can touch. They don't touch. Actually, they spirally coiled. Try to understand the view in three-dimensionally. Okay. And this coiling is called plectonemic. Why this is called plectonemic? Because we can't separate these two strands without unwinding. And the unwinding process, what is unwinding process, we will discuss during the replication process. Here you just try to remember that the coiling is plectonomic and we can't separate it. Okay. And this is a wrong concept. Two strands are meted or touched with itself. No. Actually, the two, simultaneously these two strands are passes, but not at a single point they can touch, but they can coil with each other. But that doesn't mean that they can touch with itself. Okay. And the diameter is about 20 armstrongs. Here are some informations are given. You have to just remember it for the neat examination. One turn means one curve having a distance of 34 armstrong. Okay. And within this length, 10 nucleotides are present. Means in a single turn or in a single spiral or in a curve, 10 nucleotides are present. And the average distance between the adjacent nucleotides means the distance between two adjacent nucleotides is about 3.4 armstrong. So in a single curve or a turn, the length contains 10 nucleotides, and within the two nucleotides the distance is about 3.4 armstrong. In the structure of DNA, some major and minor groups are present. We will discuss it later. In the structure of DNA, you just need to understand the double strand, that they are plectonomic in nature. They can't coil with each other. They coil with each other, but it does not mean that they can join in a point. Okay. Here, try to remember it is three-dimensional. Here it is not touched, but spirally coiled upon each other. Now, the glycosidic and phosphodiester bond. Here are two bonds are present, glycosidic and phosphodiester bond. Where the bonds are present, just see. This is the nucleotide. In the nucleotide, we know that in the middle, there is a pentose sugar or deoxyribose sugar. This is the nitrogenous base and this is the phosphate group. Carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, and this is the carbon number 5. Okay, this 5th carbon is attached with the phosphate group. Okay, through a bond, this bond is called phosphodiester bond. Okay, again, this is a third carbon. This third carbon is also attached with the phosphate group of the second nucleotide. And these two bonds are called phosphodiester bond. Try to remember where the phosphodiester bonds are located. Phosphodiester bond means fifth carbon attached with the phosphate group of the same nucleotide, and third carbon is attached with the phosphate group of second nucleotide. So these two are the phosphodiester bond. Okay, and glycosidic bond, where it is present, first carbon means the number one position. This carbon is attached with the nitrogenous bond, nitrogenous base, through a bond which is called glycosidic bonds. So clear where the two bonds are located. Nitrogenous bonds are attached with the pentose sugar through the carbon number 1, and this bond is called glycosidic bond, whereas fifth carbon of the pentose sugar attached with the phosphate group of the same nucleotide, and third carbon is attached with the another phosphate group, means the phosphate group of the second nucleotide, and these two bonds are called phosphodiester bond. Clear? Hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bonds, where it is found, see, just follow the structure. Here we have seen this adenine and thymine is bonded. In this position, the hydrogen bonds are present. Here hydrogen bonds are present. Okay, but in between the adenine and thymine, two hydrogen bonds are present. But in between the guanine and cytosine, means GC, having three hydrogen bonds. See, A double bond T. And G, in between the guanine and cytosine, three hydrogen bond occur, and this bond is more stronger than adenine-thymine bond. So these are the basic features. So in the follow my previous lecture also, first we have to know the nitrogenous base, backbone of DNA strand. Backbone of DNA strand made up of these two things, and try to understand the nucleotide structure and how the three components, means the phosphate group, sugar, and nitrogenous base, are joined with each other. Okay, polarity means the 5 prime end and the 3 prime end, which part is called 5 prime end and which part is called 3 prime end. So first thing that we have to remember, that the carbon position of the pentose sugar, one carbon, second position, third position, fourth position, and this one is the fifth position. This diagram you can easily understood, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, which carbon is attached with which group. Okay, base pairings, ATGC, A triple bond, A double bond T, whereas G triple bond C, and these two bond, glycosidic phosphodiester bond. Okay, I think you go through the notes again and again, I think you will easily understand it. Okay.